Hello and welcome back to the second part of the tutorial. Today we're gonna do the werewolf teeth. First we're gonna hide our layers we did in the previous tutorial. So we have a clean feet, and then we're gonna create a new null object. We can name it teeth upper and right, and we open our tracker window. We select our main footage and take the track motion button. Then we go to the beginning where we want to start the animation, maybe like here, and we can go to the full resolution. We take the tracking point and make it bigger so it's easier to track, and then we're gonna start the tracker. Oh, it messes up a little bit. So we go back and track it manually frame by frame. Okay, looks good. Maybe now we can automatically track again. Yeah, perfect. Okay, I think we just need it until here maybe, and then we can stop it. We can edit the target. We take our teeth upper right, press OK, and apply. We need the X and Y, and that's it. We can close that window, and we can close the tracker again. Or maybe for the next one we need it again, but yeah. We're gonna trim the layer to the important area. It's like from here until here. So we have a cleaner feed. Next step is we go a little bit closer. We create a new solid. We make it teeth color. Press OK. Wow, beautiful teeth. Turn off the null object, and we go to a good position where we want to have the teeth. And then we take the pen tool to create a mask shape. We select our solid, and we're gonna just draw how we want to have our teeth, maybe like this. Yeah, we can delete that one. Oh no, we double click, select this one, and we leave that here. Then we select all vertexes, or I don't know what it's called, vertex upstairs here, and leave that one unselected. And then we convert vertex. We take the convert vertex tool, double click, so everything is round except for the sharp edge of the teeth. Then we're gonna adjust it again like this. Maybe don't have to be very perfect. We can jump back into this later. Okay, looks fine for me. Then we're gonna trim that one as well to the perfect timing, and then we're gonna go to the pick whip tool and pick whip it to the null object so it's tracked like this. It looks fine for me. Okay, next step is our brush. Oh, we can just click on this, or we take the brush window and the paint window is all we need. And we double click on the null object. So we have here our teeth. And we need 100% opacity at first. And our size should be, 15 is okay, I guess, maybe a little bit. Like, 12, 13. And the hardness shouldn't be that hard. Maybe on 50, it's okay as well. It's very important to have the RGB mode selected. With the RGBA mode, we can draw everywhere, but we just want to draw inside the mask. So we select the RGB mode, and we just can draw inside. Then we go to the eyedropper pen, and we start with the default color of the teeth. We draw everything like that. Then we go a little bit upstairs here, where it's a bit darker, and we go at the end to that area where it's very dark. Maybe like here. Then we go to the opacity and go to like 30%. Yeah. And we smooth it out a little bit. We make something like this, and this gave it a little bit of a shaping. Maybe from here a little bit more. And then we go to a very bright part of the teeth, maybe in the front, and we make a very sharp edge like here. So it's looking very realistic. Then we can turn it back on, and wow, it looks perfect, doesn't it? No, it does not. So we go to the mask settings and make the feather to maybe 1 or 2, so it fits in a lot better. It's okay like that, maybe. So we can close that one, and we close that one as well. We go to new solid, make it black, and call it alpha teeth upper and right. Press OK. Turn it off. Make it the same comp size, layer size as the others. And we're gonna pick whip it to the teeth. Now we go closer. Go to our pen tool. Make a rough shape at the top of the teeth. Make it like that, maybe. And we make an alpha out of this. We can make it bigger. And then we invert the alpha. And the teeth just starts here. What is this? Why is this opening? Then we go to the alpha mask settings. And we feather it out. So it's very smooth on the teeth. And look at that. It's perfect. It's like my real teeth. And yeah, now next very important part is we go into the solid of the teeth, and we go into the effects and paint settings where we draw our lines. Select the first one, we go to the last one, press shift and select the last one, and then we make it comp size. Oh, here you can see what we've drawn, everything. So it starts here and ends here. Perfect. Now we go to the mask settings and go where the animation should start, maybe like here. We make a keyframe at the mask path, and maybe one where it ends, like here. Make another keyframe. Then we go to the beginning, like here maybe, and we bring all of the mask shapes to the start, how it looks, how my original teeth looks like. Then we select all and we go back to our convert vertex tool, double click, so everything is round, and maybe adjust it a little bit, and now the teeth is just growing out of my mouth perfectly. We can copy this one and go to the end and paste it like here, so it's back like this. Maybe we go to transparency on transform and opacity and go like here and turn it off like here, so it blends in and my teeth is growing out. And the same here, opacity to 100% and to 0%. If the shading on your footage is changing a lot in the mouth, you can always add a curves effect and animate it and change the color of the teeth like you need it. If it's dark or light or something, you can always change it like that, and with the stopwatch you can keyframe it. But on this footage I don't need that, so it's very good footage. And now we have one teeth, And we just have to repeat this step a lot of times. Okay, that's it for the video. I hope you enjoyed it. I'm gonna do a third video where I create all the other teeth. I just want to keep that one short as well, with the just so you know the basics how to create the teeth. If you have any questions or something, maybe watch the next video. It has maybe some more tips and tricks, I don't know. And if not, just write it into the comments. And I do my best to help you.